proposal that we need to call them and see if we can find a solution to what seems to be difficult situation between the two.
The party president of Democratic Party, Norbert Mao, for the past few weeks has been in the media over the tweets he has been making attacking the National Unity Party president, Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu, alleging that the NUP is being funded by some people within the ruling NRM party.
We believe that there is something wrong going on. Many people now are seeing as if National Unity Platform is actually going on the side of NRM, of which we don't know. We are not saying, you know, you should not go. But we petitioned the National Consultative Forum to intervene and mediate.
This has also seen some of the NUP members respond to Mao, denying the accusations leveled against their party. It's this background which has attracted the leaders of the National Consultative Forum for Political Parties and Organizations to draw strategies to resolve the seemingly growing conflicts and disputes among these two opposition political parties.
Abusing each other, which is not a good thing, not only for our individual parties, but to all of us within the opposition. So we'd like to see if we can be able to sit and find a way of resolving any of those issues that concern them.
Waswabi Jirwa, the national chairperson of Forum for Democratic Change Party, also a leader in the National Consultative Forum, says they have formed a 5-man committee which will engage the two leaders.
Committee has been instituted, which is going to invite Kyagulanyi together with his team and other people who have different divergent views, like Chairman Norbert Mao and ourselves. Then they will get to see what to do.
Gideon Tugume of Forum for Integrity in Leadership insists that they have a lot of queries which they want NUP president to answer.
So we want Kyagulanyi to come and explain. That's what we want, so that we can understand each other. But there are issues which are going on which we don't accept as the opposition. Now the whole country is seeing us as if we are part of Museveni.
Political parties without representatives in parliament under this forum are also demanding that government considers giving them annual funds for the smooth running of these parties, as it does to other political parties under the body of IPOD.
And so this has been ongoing, and we are trying to find a way of either we are looking at the law, what does the law say, and if it's not favorable to these members, then the law needs to be amended so the members receive support.
Consequently, the National Consultative Forum plenary has resolved to engage notable institutions like the Uganda Human Rights Commission, Uganda Police Force, Interreligious Council, among others, to see that the current trends of torture and human rights violations come to an end. Story by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.
Yes.